Hey, it's AJ Lester from unleashawesome.com. Well, I'm back again with another video, and in the previous video I talked about a few little insights and strategies that I've learned are useful for overcoming perfectionism, and I've already been using them myself, and so I shared them so other people might find them useful. Now in this video I want to just extend and expand on that a little bit. I've got a couple more insights that have come from really thinking about this topic of perfectionism and how I can actually make progress on overcoming it. So these are a little bit less practical, they're more philosophical or mindset based, but I think if they do help to change your mindset a little bit, then they can obviously help with the practical application and the actions you need to take to overcome perfectionism. So once again, these are little insights or thoughts or mindset shifts that I've found useful myself, and I wanted to share them in case you find them useful as well. So the first one is that when it comes to being a perfectionist or the level of effort that you put into a particular job that you're working on, really what you want to focus on is what's required to achieve the outcome. So, you know, if you find that you are a perfectionist and you're always just getting everything to 100% no matter what you'll probably see if you have a look at it is that most of the time, a 100% result was not actually necessary to achieve the outcome that you wanted. So, for example, these YouTube videos that I'm making, what's the outcome that I want? Well, I've got some really cool stuff that I want to share. I want to get it out there to the world. I want to teach people. I want to share with them. I want to give them things that give them value, so hopefully they can use it and apply it in their own lives to really move forward and achieve the things that they want to achieve. Now, if I have that outcome and then I don't make the perfect video, I'm still actually going to be able to achieve that outcome if I do a good enough job. So, you know, when I do these videos, they're so far from perfect, and I can't help but notice that, but obviously because I'm actually working towards overcoming perfectionism, I'm actually just letting a lot of that stuff go and just saying, so be it, having a laugh at it, as I talked about in the video yesterday, and then just putting it out there. So, you know, just to be very clear, I realize that I talk too quickly and I don't take enough pauses, and that's something that I need to practice and work on, but it's not a reason for me to just stop and redo the take all over again. I realize that these videos aren't the best structure. Sometimes I repeat myself, sometimes I say things in a very ambiguous way and it's not as clear as it could be. And so, you know, maybe it takes me 5 minutes to say something that I could probably explain in a minute and a half. I know that, you know, sometimes my use of my body and my facial expressions, it isn't always the, when I look at it, I cringe a little bit at what it looks like because it's not really how I want to look. I know that I sometimes have this thing where I cock my head to the side, one side or the other, and it kind of stays there and it's a little bit off-putting sometimes when I look at it. There's all sorts of things like that that aren't perfect. But with all of that stuff in there, if I get these videos out to the world, I'm still going to achieve the outcome. There's still stuff in there that even if it takes 5 minutes to get there, someone's going to look at that and think, yep, there was some good stuff in there and they can take it away and use it, so I've achieved the outcome. And there's a lot of things like that in life where if you just do things maybe to 80% or an 8 out of 10, you're definitely going to achieve the outcome. And this is something that I'm aware of because I watched a lot of other YouTube videos on overcoming perfectionism. And in these videos, I'm keen not to just repeat the advice that's out there, which is all really good, but there's no need for me to repeat it because someone else has already said it a lot. And so I wanted to sort of give a different take on this, which is, you know, to base, you know, some people say, oh, just do everything to an 80% level and that's good enough. But what I think is important is really to decide what level you go to based on what the outcome is that you want to achieve. Sometimes a 50%, a 5 out of 10 is good enough. You know, if I'm making notes for myself just to remind myself of something, I type it up and there's all sorts of spelling mistakes or I don't capitalize things or words have run together or whatever, it might look like an absolute dog's breakfast, but when I look at it, that's going to jog my memory, it's going to serve the outcome, which was just a reminder. It doesn't have to be beautifully typed up with capital letters in the right space, places and perfect spelling and all that kind of thing. So it might be a 5 out of 10 if I was submitting it as an academic essay, but it actually achieves the outcome, so I don't even need to get it to an 8 out of 10. A 5 out of 10 is good enough. Other cases, 8 out of 10 is good enough. And of course, it's important to remember that even though we're trying to overcome perfectionism, which as I said, the root of that as I see it is in fear of failure, criticism, judgment, rejection, and all those kinds of things. We're trying to overcome that and detach ourselves from all the fear and the discomfort around those things, and as a result, not feel compelled to always do the perfect job no matter what at the expense of other things that we could be doing. Even though that's the goal, there are some situations it's important to acknowledge where we need to actually do a perfect job. You know, if you were a building surveyor or a land surveyor and you don't put the pegs in the right spot, well, there's going to be some big consequences there. People are paying you to put the pegs in the perfect spot. You know, if you're a brain surgeon and, you know, you don't do the perfect job when you're doing the surgery, then that could be major, have major consequences on someone's life. They could die or they could have a really impaired life. That's a big deal. And so, you know, you might be aiming for a 9.9 or a 10 out of 10 in that sort of situation. If you're a bomb diffuser and you don't do a perfect job, well, you and a whole bunch of people are going to blow up. So there's lots of situations where it is important to do a perfect job, but it's important, I think, in this topic, that the motivation is just that you need to do a good job, not that there's going to be judgment, criticism, you know, the failure and all these different fears and discomforts coming up. That's not the motivation. The motivation is it's your job to get this job right, and that's why you're doing it. So that's one thing that I wanted to mention there, which is basically match the level of effort and how perfect you make it to the outcome you're trying to achieve, and don't go much beyond that. Because if you go beyond that, it's really just for you so that you feel more comfortable, and it's not really helping anybody else, and it's certainly not helping you in the big picture, because it's just keeping you attached to that perfectionism and not freeing you of the emotions and the psychology that's underlying that. So that's insight number one that I wanted to share with you. But insight number two, which is even more, it's a bit more philosophical, and it's, like I said, just a bit more of a mindset thing, is that every time you put in excessive effort to make one thing perfect, there's a chance that you're actually making something else imperfect. And so the moral of the story, and I'll explain this in more depth, but the moral of the story is, even by making some things perfect, it's actually coming at a cost of making something else imperfect. So being perfect is actually being imperfect in a lot of cases. So what I mean by that is, let's say, for example, and I'll use these YouTube videos because it's basically just a fixed project that you can spend a certain amount of time on, and you can take it as far as you want to go. You can slap something out in 2 seconds flat, or you can spend a bit of time preparing it and then taking a nice take, or you can plan it to the nth degree and take a million takes and patch it all together and edit it beautifully and doing all that other stuff and really make it perfect. So with these videos, if I spend all that time, you know, I spend a whole day producing just one video, or I spend a week producing one video and it's the perfect video, well, I might have made that video perfect, but what I've done is make the rest of my life imperfect. So it's making my emotional state imperfect, because I know that, you know, even though I tend in the past, you know, the former me likes to have things perfect, I don't actually enjoy the process of making things perfect. So, for example, you know, I really love starting things and getting things happening to begin with, because that's all new and exciting, and the novelty really gives my emotional state a big lift. But I really don't enjoy finishing things off and making them perfect. All that time it takes to polish everything up, that's not enjoyable for me. That's not a good part of the process for me. And so I usually just find it tedious and frustrating and that kind of thing. So if I engage too much in that kind of behavior to make something perfect, then my emotional state becomes imperfect. I don't have the excitement and the juice that I really want, which would be a 10 out of 10 emotional state. Some of it's 10 out of 10 because it's the starting bit, but then all the rest of it, that might be a 3 or a 4 out of 10. So my emotional state's imperfect. By extension, my day becomes imperfect, because there might be all these cool things that I want to do throughout the day. And let's say that, you know, the perfect day, there were 10 really awesome things in it, but if I spend all day on this one video, then I haven't done all 10 of those things, so some other things were missing. So I didn't make my day perfect, I actually made it imperfect by trying to make this one video perfect. And obviously you can extend that out as far as you want. You know, the big picture in my life, if I spend forever just planning and preparing and then polishing things up and just making everything perfect, I might get a few really perfect things out there, but my whole life is going to be filled with missed opportunities because I couldn't do this thing over here because I was too busy making this thing over here perfect. And so if I look at my whole life in the big picture, that's also going to be imperfect. So it's something to keep in mind. Every time you put in excess effort to make one thing perfect, you're actually costing yourself somewhere else and making that imperfect. And so all the pursuit of perfection that you have is actually unraveling anyway, and you're not really achieving in the big picture that perfectionism that you were trying to achieve. Now, of course, if it's something like a YouTube video, you might do that because you're worried about people thinking badly of you if it's not perfect, and no one's really looking at your life and saying, you know, his life was imperfect on the whole because he spent too long making this video. But it's something that's important to remember for just at least your own knowledge, that you can't really have perfectionism across the whole of your life. You're going to have just patches of perfectionism in a sea of imperfection. And wouldn't you rather have a perfect big picture life, a perfect emotional state and some really perfect days, rather than making the little things that you do perfect in and of themselves? Something to think about anyway. So those are two other insights. Like I said, I found them useful in my own situation, and I hope you will find them useful in your own situation as well if you are struggling with perfectionism and you want to overcome it and you want to come on this journey as well. So take them on board. If you want to discuss things, as always, throw some comments down below. Feel free to subscribe so you can get notifications when the videos come out. But even if you don't subscribe, you can rely on me being back again here tomorrow, and I'll have even more stuff to share with you. So enjoy, and until then, have fun with it, apply what you can, and I'll see you back here tomorrow. Ciao for now.